Okay, speaking of representing, we have Jonathan Sawyer here with his second cookbook, The Power of Sour. All right, man, and you're working that out. I'm just going to let that sit there. I'm not even going to touch that.
All right.
House of Vinegar. All right, so
here we go.
We made two dishes.
Yes.
And talk about the two dishes.
So here we have Devils on Horseback, classic old English dish with a modern twist.
Gotcha.
Sweet onion sous vide, chocolate, chili, dates, double smoked bacon from Ohio, of course.
Wow.
And a little bit of almonds.
And then to match the dishes, you prepared probably one of the drinks that's... in the book?
True story.
Yeah, yeah.
So this is the Sazerac from the book. We're using Watershed Bourbon.
Mm-hmm.
We're using a splash of Bullet Rye, a little bit of our vinegar, orange peel. And that's it.
Now, for people just joining us, talk about the concept. You said one of the common things people forget about is vinegar when they're making tasty meals.
Yeah, I think everyone only associates vinegar with salad dressing.
And that's it.
Right, and that's it. That's the only use. But I'm a former engineer, and I always think about cooking like an equation.
Right.
So salt, salt,
right.
Sweet, acid, fat, umami. So that acid can be vinegar, and actually it's easier for you to support your local agronomy if it's local vinegar, because we're not growing lemons, limes, and oranges here.
Right.
So what we started doing 10 years ago here, or 12 years ago at Lolita, or whenever it was we started replacing little bits of vinegar, or of citrus with vinegar.
Okay.
Started to figure out, okay, we can replace all of it over here, a little bit over here.
Yeah.
And over those years, we've developed recipes, and this book is just showcasing some of the great techniques. And it also allows you to dive a little bit deeper if you're a nerd like I am and you want to know how to make vinegar.
Right.
You can do it. If you're terrified by that, it's only
okay.
One chapter.
Right.
16
boom,
pages.
Boom.
You just skip it.
You have some good stuff happening over in the Van Aken district over there?
We do. So we've been working on a project for about 5 years in downtown Shaker, which is the Van Aken district.
Mm-hmm.
And it's 49 acres full, but we're opening up our next and really our most ambitious restaurant since opening here in the springtime there.
Okay.
And we're joined by tons of locals, some national talent as well.
Yeah.
It's really the most exciting group of restaurants to open in the city of Cleveland probably since East 4th started.
My big question is, why are you doing that when you have a 13-year-old at home, you have a teenager, and a 11-year-old who's about to become a teenager. So you're going to have a new restaurant, a great wife, and a house full of teenagers in about a year or two with that's going to be fun, man.
Yeah, and I'll start writing my next book, and then
so just to escape to daddy's room, you're going to start writing the next book
with
two teenagers?
Yes. What are you doing? I'm writing.
Leave daddy alone.
He's writing. Meanwhile, I'm just
you can get these on Amazon and local bookstores.
Yeah, if you want an autographed copy of the book, you can come to Noodle Cat, Trentina, or the Greenhouse Tavern. I've pre-signed all of them.
Well done,
and we can personalize them for you.
Boom. And again, millennials, this is called a book.
They're
really, really neat.
Book.
Yes.
Really? What do you mean with that?